One-way fluid structure interaction, or FSI, studies the effect of fluid forces on a structure. In this process, fluid pressure is imported into the static structural system. We will couple Fluent with the static structural analysis, so we need two different systems. Hello, I'm Armin. Before we begin, I'd like to give a brief explanation of FSI. Let's get started. Fluid structure interaction, or FSI, describes the interplay between fluids and solid structures. It involves analyzing how the fluid's motion impacts a structure and how the structure responds by altering the fluid flow. This phenomenon is common in aerospace, biomedical devices, and civil engineering. Understanding FSI ensures safe and efficient designs of systems like bridges, airplane wings, and heart valves. FSI is categorized into one-way and two-way interactions. In one-way FSI, fluid forces impact the structure, but structural changes do not alter the fluid flow. This is ideal for systems where deformation is minimal. Two-way FSI, on the other hand, involves a continuous feedback loop between the fluid and structure, making it essential for scenarios with significant coupling, such as modeling the operation of heart valves and blood flow. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to model a valve with fluid passing through it. This is a one-way FSI simulation because the valve's deformation is negligible. The process requires coupling Fluent with the static structural system. The blue-colored body represents the fluid domain, which will be analyzed in Fluent. In contrast, the orange-colored body represents the solid part used in the static structural analysis. I've extended the inlet and outlet of the fluid domain to improve convergence during the solution process. By the end of this tutorial, we'll explore the results, including the pressure and velocity within the fluid and the stress and deformation in the solid part. Let's get started modeling. Let's start this tutorial on fluid structure interaction using ANSYS. We can find FSI in the custom systems. First, I'll expand the custom system and double-click on the FSI system with Fluent. As shown, the FSI system integrates fluid flow and static structural modules, sharing both geometry and solution data. To begin, I need to import the geometry into the fluid flow system. I'll right-click on the geometry cell and select Browse. I will select the file and click Open. Since I prefer preparing geometry in Space Claim, I'll choose that option. For this tutorial, I'm using a simplified valve geometry. In the fluid flow system, I need to create a fluid domain. To do this, I'll navigate to the Prepare tab and use the Volume Extract tool. There are several methods for extracting volumes, but I'll use the Edges option. I'll select three edges that define the valve's edge boundaries and click the green checkmark. The fluid volume is now extracted. To exit the Volume Extract tool, I'll press Escape. Next, I'll rename the extracted volume to fluid and the other part to solid. I'll also move up the fluid part in the structure tree and delete the volume component. Boundary condition definitions are essential for Fluent models. This surface is the inlet, so I'll name it inlet using the Groups tab. I'll click Create ANSYS and type inlet. Similarly, I'll name the outlet. I want to assign names to the walls in the Fluent model, so I will hide the solid part. For the walls, which interact with the solid structure, I'll select all surfaces except the inlet, outlet, and top surfaces. You can hold Ctrl and click to select or deselect surfaces. Once selected, I'll click Create an S and name the group walls. Any redundant names will be removed for clarity. The inlet and outlet pipes are too short, which slows down convergence. I'll extend the inlet and outlet by 100 mm using the pull tool to resolve this. This difference won't affect the results, but will improve convergence. I will make the solid part visible again. After extrusion, I'll investigate whether the names for each boundary remain unchanged. Everything is correct, I will close the space claim. It's time to prepare the mesh. I will double-click on the mesh cell and wait for it to open. The geometry consists of both solid and fluid domains. Since the solid part is not required in Fluent, I will suppress it in the outline window. Now, we can define the mesh properties for the fluid domain. First, I will generate the default mesh to evaluate it. The default mesh is coarse and not suitable for CFD simulations. To refine it, I will right-click on the mesh and select the sizing option. Using the body selector in the top ribbon, I will choose the fluid domain and set the element size to 3 mm. Let's generate the mesh again and review the results. Next, we need to add an inflation layer to improve the solution's resolution. We can find it by right-clicking on the mesh. First, I will select the body. Next, I will choose the outer surface of the geometry and keep the default options unchanged. Finally, I will click the Apply button. I will regenerate the mesh. This warning indicates that there are stair steps in the mesh. However, it's not a significant issue. As you can see, 5 inflation layers have been created along the walls, as the maximum number of layers is set to 5 by default. I've already specified the names in space claim, so redefining them in the mesh is unnecessary. Everything is set up correctly, and I will close the mesh module. We need to update the mesh again. Now, I will double-click on the setup cell. In the setup, we need to enable double precision, specify the number of processors, and click Start to prepare the model. Since one-way FSI is a steady-state simulation, I won't change the time settings. In the material section, I need to replace air with water. To do this, I will right-click on the fluid option and select New. The Fluent database contains a wide range of materials. I will search for liquid water in the database, select it, and click Copy. Then, I'll close the window. Now, both air and liquid water appear in the fluid subsection. Next, we need to update the material in the cell zone. I will expand the cell zone, right-click on the domain, and select Edit. Next, I will change the material from air to water in the material name field. Finally, I will click Apply to update the material to water. Let's move on to defining the boundary conditions. The inlet boundary condition is set to velocity by default, and I won't change it. I will open the inlet settings and specify a velocity magnitude of, for example, 5 meters per second, then click Apply. The outlet boundary condition is set to pressure outlet by default, but since the outlet pressure velocity is unknown, I will change it to outflow for this simulation. We can only use the outflow boundary condition for incompressible fluids, like water. Now that the boundary conditions are set, I'll explain the solution process. First, I'll click on Methods. ANSYS Fluent has four solution schemes. Since the fluid is incompressible, the PISO method is better because it's faster. I will also enable the local time step in the pseudo time method, but I won't change anything else. In the controls window, the pseudo time current number is 5. I haven't changed the default settings. Next, I'll navigate to the initialization window and click on Initialize. As you can see, convergence hasn't been reached yet because I used water. Now, I'll navigate to run calculation. In this window, I'll set the number of iterations to 100 and click Calculate. After 300 iterations, the solution still hasn't converged. To fix this, I'll change the initialization method. I'll return to the Initialization tab, set the method to Standard, select the inlet, and click Initialize. Now, I will solve it again. As you can see, this method helps the solution converge. I'll pause the calculation here since this is enough for educational purposes. Next, we can create contours to visualize the results. I'll add a contour to plot the pressure and create a plane in the XY direction to show the pressure inside the valve. I will click the New Surface button and select the plane. I want to create a plane in the XY direction, and now it's ready to use. We can also look at the velocity field. Even though the solution hasn't fully converged, the results are good enough for now. Finally, I will close Fluent. Everything is correct so far. Now, I need to set up the static structural system. I won't change the default material, so I'll proceed to the model. As you can see, there are two domains, solid and fluid. Since the fluid domain isn't needed for static structural analysis, I'll suppress it. To do this, I'll right-click on it in the geometry and select Suppress Body. We can change the material by clicking on the solid part. The default material is structural steel, which I won't change, but you can select any material you prefer. Next, I'll move to the mesh. First, I'll generate the default mesh to check the resolution. As you can see, the mesh is slightly coarse. To refine it, I'll right-click on the mesh and choose sizing. Then, I'll select the body from the top ribbon, choose the solid domain, and click Apply. Here is the default element size. I think 5 millimeters is sufficient, so I'll specify it and update the mesh. The element size looks good now. Next, let's add boundary conditions. These holes are for the bolts and nuts, so we must specify a proper boundary condition. I'll right-click on the solid structure and select cylindrical support from the menu. Then, I'll choose all the holes and click Apply. In the Details window, we can adjust the boundary conditions. All directions are fixed, and I won't make any changes. Now, We need to import the fluid load into the solid part. I'll navigate to imported load, right-click, and select pressure. In the details window, I'll change the inlet to the walls of the CFD source under the transfer definition. Then, in the scope, I'll select the interior walls of the valve. Everything looks correct, so I'll right-click and select Import Load. As you can see, the fluid pressure is now applied to the interior of the solid. Finally, I'll solve the model by right-clicking and selecting Solve. The solution is complete. Now, we can view the results. I will select von Mises stress by right-clicking on Solution and clicking Evaluate. This shows the stress distribution on the valve caused by the fluid. Next, let's check the deformation. I'll right-click on Solution and choose Total Deformation. The deformation is small, and the stress is not significant. I will play the animation by clicking this button. We can also hide elements here to view the parts better. This concludes the tutorial. Please like and subscribe to the channel for more videos.